Hi, I'm Brandon Burton with Legend Brands. Today I'm here to talk about the quality and design differences between the LGR Evolution by Dri-Eaz and the R150 by Phoenix. One of the first things that we notice as a difference between these two machines is in the overall stability. We notice here with the Evolution, much as we do with all Dri-Eaz dehumidification systems, that our axle and wheel hub have a very, very tight tolerance, making the machine very, very stable. Over here on the 150, we notice there's a significant amount of wobble and play. This is because the axle and the wheelbase are not nearly as tight in their tolerance. When it comes to designing a quality dehumidifier, fit and function is key. One of the things that we notice here from the top of this machine is how exceptionally loose this filter is within this filter shroud. This allows for a lot of bypass air moving around your filter, and if there's bypass, that means that we have a lot of particulate that's going to make its way down into the coil assembly. And particulate collecting on the coil assembly is either going to elevate the amount of maintenance necessary or significantly slow the performance on the machine. When we pull this filter out from this assembly here, we can also notice inside that we have direct access into the blower wheel assembly inside the machine. Later, when we take a look at the inside, I'll give you another look at this, but you can notice that I can reach all the way down into this shroud and physically grab this blower wheel assembly. This is a significant safety issue, because if this blower were indeed spinning and I grabbed those blades, I'd cause significant injury to my fingers. In contrast, over here on the Evolution, what we'll note is that, first of all, not only is the filter very well protected, but notice how tight our form and fit is on this filter seal. This ensures that we cannot have any bypass air making its way into the actual filter assembly. Also notice that I have zero access into my blower assembly or any moving parts within the machine. Another very significant design difference between the two machines is the way that the handle is managed. We can notice over here on the Evolution how quickly we can deploy the handle assembly and how secure the unit is with the handle deployed, so we can very rapidly mobilize the unit. Over here on the 150, however, in order to deploy the handle, first of all, I have to back out two star nuts completely from the housing in the machine. I now have two loose pieces here that I could easily lose or misplace. Once the handle is deployed, then I have to again reinsert these star nuts in order to secure the handle. I have to be very careful that I have to line up my holes here, make sure I don't cross-thread anything, which over many, many use cycles could potentially make the handle inoperable. Then once the handle is deployed, again, notice how wobbly the machine is. Now, this is not only because of the way the handle is being managed, it's also because of the foundation we're on here with the wheel and the very loose tolerance on the axle assembly. Now, from the back of the machines, we can also notice a number of quality and design differences. The first thing here is just notice the cord assembly here on the R150 and how there is really no meaningful place to store that cord. There's no meaningful wrap here. On the Evolution, we notice that we've got a very pronounced cord wrap here on the pipe that keeps the cord very secure. And down here on the bottom, we do have also an additional place for your hose management that has a quick release function so that we can very rapidly remove the hose from the back of the machine. Then finally, while we're here, we notice the skid rail assembly and how that's built out to ensure that we can have no contact with any of these components on the back, versus here with the R150. There isn't much of a skid rail assembly here, and because of that, we can notice that the hose is actually pronounced beyond the back surface, allowing us to catch while we're loading and unloading from the van. We notice the same thing here with the power cord assembly. We can see how this is sticking out, and as we make contact during loading and unloading, it's going to put a lot of stress on the strain relief and potentially cause your conductors inside the wire to fail. And then finally, last with the touchpad controls, you'll notice when we actually remove these touchpads, first of all, on the 150, we notice how loose the electrical box is here. It comes right out of the machine. But also notice how there aren't any electrical components being stored within the electrical box. In contrast, over here with the Evolution, when we remove the touchpad, first of all, we notice that the electrical box is very secure. It's not coming out of the machine. But we also notice that within the electrical box, we have our capacitor that is properly protected within the area, a number of other electrical components that are up here within the lid of the electrical box. This is to ensure that there's no access to these components from within the machine during maintenance, and also to ensure that our humid airstream and the moisture has no potential to come into contact with these very critical components. In addition to what we can see from the outside of the machine and the overall differences in design and quality, there are a number of things that are really best seen if we take a look at the machines from the inside. First, we'll start down here with the electrical components, and we can see how these are out in the open air stream and not enclosed in any way, allowing the electrical components in the wire harness to come in direct contact with this very hot compressor body. Also leaving things like the capacitor here and here out and accessible and in the open airstream and mounted to the plastic housing. Where in contrast over here with our Evolution, our electrical components and our wire harness are properly shielded and protected in a separate metal box in compliance with UL listing. Notice how the cap tube here on this unit is out in the airstream, and it's also immediately next to and adjacent to this evaporator coil. Any vibration in this cap tube during operation is going to have this cap tube touching the fins on this coil, which can cause abrasion and wear over time, and ultimately can cause the entire sealed system to fail. Another point of note here is notice how sharp the bends are on the edge of this capillary tube. They're supposed to be very gradual, like you see in this coil of tubing here, because a sharp bend like this is going to create a restriction within the cap tube, and it's going to improperly manage pressures within the coil system. In contrast, notice over here on the Evolution how our capillary tube, first of all, is protected here in this plastic sheath. It's away from any of the sharp edges on the coil assembly itself, and all of the bends are very gradual. We ensure that there is no sharp bend that's going to create an undue restriction in the refrigeration flow, which ultimately influences how the pressures are managed in the coils and how we dehumidify with the cold evaporator. One of the most important things with any piece of equipment that we leave behind in a customer's property is safety. And one major safety issue with this overall design is my ability to access this blower wheel. If we simply remove the filter from the dehumidifier, I can reach into this area of the filter and put my fingers all the way down into this blower wheel assembly. If this were an operation and this were spinning, reaching into that blower wheel would cause significant injury to my fingers.